One another is with the children. If you look at the way he taught Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, his mother came when he was a young boy in early, like 7, 8 years old, came in and she said, I want him to serve you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took him, and it's important because Anas becomes one of the greatest teachers of Sahaba. Somebody grew up in the Bayt al-Nabuwa, spent 10 years. He said, I served the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 10 years. He never once struck me. He never once said to me, if I did something wrong, why did you do that thing? And if I did something, if I didn't do a thing he asked me, why didn't you do it? Never once in 10 years. Anas said, once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came in and he said, yeah, Anas, can you go and do such and such? And he said, no. He's a young boy, boys do that, right? He's a young boy, they do that. The Prophet smiled, ibtisam, and then he left the room. That's it, that is, really, this is very significant. This is something children, they expect you to get mad, they want to challenge you. He smiled, and he smiled at them, and then he left the room. You see, you have to leave it, right? He came back a little while later and he said, Anas, did you do that thing I asked you? He said, I'm going right now. It's amazing, tarbiyah, look at the children that grew up around him, Abdullah ibn Zubair. When Umar came down the road, all the children ran away, except for Abdullah ibn Zubair. And Umar said, why don't you run? He said, I didn't do anything wrong that I should be afraid of you, and the road's wide enough to suit both of us. The Anas ibn Malik had a little boy, a little brother named Abu Umair. And Abu Umair, his father got him a little bird that he used to play with, they call it Nughar, the little type of bird. And he said, كَانَ يَدْخُرُ عَلَيْنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَزُورُهُمْ. He used to visit them sometime. And the Prophet ﷺ, once he came over and he saw Abu Umair was sad, كان حزينا. فسأله ما شأنه. He's concerned, he's coming to visit the family, he sees one of the family members is depressed. Like some people, they go in, they're not even aware of states of people. He came in, he looked, he saw he's depressed. ما شأنه. He's a little boy, he was younger than Anas, little child. ما شأنه. They said, مات نغره. His little bird died. So the Prophet ﷺ went up to him and he said, Ya Abu Umair, ma fa'al al-Nughair? Abu Umair, what did the little Nughair, what did it do? Subhanallah. Ma fa'al al-Nughair? It's a deep question. He's asking the boy, one, becoming aware of death. What did the little bird do? It died. This is the nature of the world. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani says about that hadith, over 100 mas'ala have been derived from that hadith. Over 100. From that one hadith, over 100 mas'ala have been derived. You see, all of his actions were teaching. All of them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once he was walking with Hussein on his shoulders, and a man passed by and he said, Ni'm al-Markab to Hussein. What an excellent riding markab is what you ride on. What an excellent riding vehicle you have. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Ni'm al-Rakib. What an excellent rider. Right? You see, tashreef, like honoring the child. You know, giving him importance. And this is what the Prophet did. He made people feel important. He gave them importance.
محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن